Hey, I've got something trapped over in my car over here. We'll go over and have a look and see what we've got there, eh? I think you'll be pretty keen to see this, because I'm pretty keen to get it out. So let's go have a look. Time to let you out. Come on, out we come. Got these little balls. They go in each corner. That's what the Vibralap vibrates on. Corresponding divots on the other side. And then it's got the ring, goes around the inside. Clamps get done up, and away it goes. Now we'll do a bit of a walk around. I picked this up from a mate in the rock club. He didn't want it any longer. It looks like it's homemade. There's no labels or anything to say who's made it. It's obviously had some sort of device. So it goes up and over these, the bolt in each of these corners, and some sort of spring tension device there, I'd say. I've seen things similar to that in the past. But yeah, can't wait to flash it up and chuck some rock on it. Now, go choose some rocks out of the garden that I've slabbed. There's a few that you already cut. So we'll give those a go and see what they look like all shinied up. Yeah, so I don't think I'll get to go to try it out today, because I've got the Sparkies coming into work and I've got to go in and open up so that they can change the fluorescent lights in the shop to LED ones. So I can't wait to get in and have a go at this, see how it works. So yep, but later on it'll be me. This is the Vibralap. My workshop's getting a little bit noisy now. I've got the rotary tumbler going, I've got the Vibe going, and now the Vibralap. This is the 8100 grit. Just comes through the first stage. I left it running while I went to work, but unfortunately my nice big agate here stopped in the middle, and you can see all the lines running through from in here where it stopped in March. I read it could do that and it's done it, so I'm gonna have to clean all this out and chuck it in for another go. Now always live and learn. I've gone and put a 100 grit in, been a little bit of water, still deciding how much water needs to be on it. You probably saw when I first started it was fairly full, because that's what I've seen others do, but in subsequent readings it seems to be less is better, but you got to watch it more often. So I think because I go away for 8 hours, which is not advisable, because you end up with that sort of thing happening. You can see all the lines in it. Having more water in will give it more room to move around, I think. Oh, let's chuck it on, see how it goes. My watches are come loose, so I better pipe them over. No, this is now the 220 grit. I will go and put this here in. It's had all those groove marks. Sent it out yesterday. So I'll just put this in by itself. And see how that goes. And then I'll put these in when I finish that. Now that seems to be rotating better. I put an old dive weight on top. and I put a ring around it with an old hose, and now it doesn't appear to be getting stuck in the corner. So hopefully, this will be better. I'm going to change these bolts out, because as you can see, the wing nuts don't stack up to the job. So I've got some of these. Now we'll put those on, level out the plate, and get this Thunder Egg back and running again. So we'll be doing 400 grit. So we'll get into it. So we've got to level up the plate. I've got a bubble coming that sit on the center to get it more accurate, because I'm not sure just how square the plate is to the edge rim. We'll put some washers down in here to give me a level that way, and then we'll go this way. Probably can go up a little bit on that side. So I've already got, where are we, two washers there. So we'll chuck another one on. So we've got three washers in there now. And we'll level that way. And we'll level that way, so I can do the bolts up, and we'll be good to go. I'll just do the bolts up until it's just snug. Check our levels again. Yep, and the other way. Yep, go. So let's rock and roll. Here we go. We got some 400 grit. Oh, we'll probably chuck, I don't know, 3 odd tablespoons in there. See how it goes. Still just getting my amounts right, but we'll try 3 tablespoons and we'll go from there. Last time I put some water in, I didn't put enough in and it ran out. Now we'll put enough in to cover the. So that just goes nicely to the edges. So we'll give this a sure it's all and then we'll finger out of the picture, but we'll go and plug it in. Got it vibrating away. We'll put our Thunder Egg in. Nice and gently. Let's see. doesn't appear to be moving too well, so we'll add some weight to it. One thing that I forgot to do was put the ring on. So we'll go put the ring on. Now there we go, it's starting to move. Now I'm home, I can come check on it regularly just make sure it hasn't got stuck or run out of water. Expecting a high of 18 degrees Celsius today here inside the garage. Probably get a bit warmer than that. So evaporation's going to be a thing. Yeah, we'll see how this goes. I might wash up some of the other stones that I've been doing ready for when I pull this out tonight. This is the 600 grit last stage. I just had this coming up. I'll dry it off because it's still wet before we go on to the polish stage. This is looking pretty good so far. So here's 600 grit. Not sure if you can see, got a little bit of a polish. So we'll go in and stick it on the polish to it. Now I've gone and put the carpet in. I've got a new bumper ring. I don't want to transfer any grip from the old one to this. I've turned the plate upside down so that we're on a fresh new clean. So this side is only for polishing and the underneath side is for the grip. So from what I've read, 4 tablespoons of tumble polish onto the carpet and make into a fine slurry. But because it's a fresh new carpet, I said it might need more. So I'll start off 6 tablespoons and see how we go from there. So we've got our 6 tablespoons of polish on. I'll add some water, make a slurry, and we'll see how that goes. Ah, there we go. So we'll go and plug it in and see if it gonna work. Trying to do it one handed. There we go. Look at that, it moves. I'm quite happy with how it's come out. Got quite a nice polish. It's not the best. Given the type of stone, I think it's actually come out quite well. I'll come and release you, mate.